Hi, this is Pat again, the sales engineer, and we're going to go over now the Kaigelu, the K-A-I-G-E-L-U, Kaigelu 316. This one I got in today, and it is spelled K-A-I, where's my starter ink? A-I. G-E-L-U number 316. Now, I just filled this up, and it's actually a really remarkable pen. This is what they're calling white-veined, and I got this at iSellPens.com. Todd there at iSellPens.com has this for $19.99, and it's got some weight to it, and I find really refreshing. I don't know what the Kaigelu logo is, but it looks like a fish with a cockpit on the front of it with a blue background. Not sure where that comes from, but you know the Japanese. This has what I'm usually not a big fan of, which is the acrylic on metal. They never seem to work well together. It always tears up the acrylic. This has a ball in the ink, which is an interesting feature that I am just seeing very rarely, which allows the pen to sit in this position vertically and act as somewhat of a stopgap for all of the ink coming out. Normally, when you're using the pen, the ball actually sits, because it's at an angle, the ball actually sits such that the ink goes over and around it. Now, this is really interesting because when I filled this, I noticed, because I didn't want to really tarnish up the nib, I took the refill out, and the refill cartridge screws in. I've never had, even in the higher end pens, one that screws in nice. You know it's not going to pop out. Very, very nice to work with. Then you can see it's well appointed. It has Kaigelu engraved. It's a vibration engravement in here. And let's see, there's the number 316 on the body. It's got a beautiful kind of a curve for the fingers going down and then coming up at the end. So as you look at this right here, it's got a curve in and out, a curve in and out like that. So it's not like you see these with, you know, just a normal kind of a halfway curve. So it's a nice change. I've got Lamy in here because I really wanted to see what this thing had. Very heavy, again, heavy ends to these. Heavy end to the body, which swings the weight this way. I mean, it's very heavy. For me to balance it with a full ink reservoir, it's about there. You know, that's how much weight is here compared to there. And that's, again, with a full reservoir. There's no snapping mechanism or anything for this little guy. You can see she fits right up onto here. Fairly snug. Not as snug as I'd rather it be. But the appointments are nice. The black and the gold goes really well with this black acrylic. This is a very, very deep finish. I'm sure the camera isn't doing any justice to it, but quite impressive. Now, with this part being just as heavy, if not heavier, than the end of the body at the end of the cap, this pen just wants to just lift right up off the paper. So you're about pushing just to get it, the nib, to be on the paper. So a beautiful 14 karat and chrome nib in intricate engraving, and nothing really of note there, except it's got the Kaigelu, apparently that's their logo again. It might be a plant or something coming out of it. Yeah, I guess it's a plant. Awful weird looking planter. It looks more like a fish that's got its face down into a planter. But didn't look like she was a very good starter right there, but a nice broad nib, and there's no doubt where it should be. It's so far offset from the center unlike the lighter pens, that you can actually feel when, I mean, she sort of rests right where it should be with the nib pointing straight up. So again, that's the second time she wasn't a good starter. Let's see how she is once she gets going. This is definitely not a fine pen. And I'm giving it a little bit of force here. We can see the misses that we have here. And okay, let's get a new sheet. And let's put it through the eights. Not perfect. In here we can see, this is probably due to pressure fluctuations on my part. Okay, you can see it did a lot better there. And again, depending on how I hold it, see, she wasn't a good starter here, but now if I tilt the pen a little bit, much, much better. And let's take it to the racetrack. Really not that impressive. For a $20 pen, I really shouldn't be seeing this kind of skipping, especially with a medium. You know, I've got a cross here that I know can beat it on the racetrack. That's what it should be able to do. And that's a medium. It's supposed to be a medium, but it says it's a medium. She doesn't like performing coming up. Going down, of course, when we start to open up the gap, she does better. So not seeing any kind of nib creep, but it does look like much, much happier going down than up. And that could be the result of the nib's design. Although, as I look at it, we've got just as much of a rise on the top as on the bottom. So there really shouldn't be any excuse for it not to be able to give me nice flow going up like this. Down, no problem. And that's it. This looks more like a signature kind of a pen than it does an everyday write lots with it kind of a pen. And the reason I say that is because not only is it very, I don't know, I don't know how to put it, it's more touchy with regard to position than it should be, the rotation of the whole nib, but she has trouble in the up direction here. A lot, and that really shouldn't happen. So I might be able to clean this, I might be able to soak it a little bit, because I really want to like this pen. I like the look of it and everything. It's got the right price, so it should be, you know, behaving better than this. And it's got a more, you know, the modern feed here, the square plastic feed, so there's no excuses there. And that's it. This is the Kaijulu 316 in white veined from iSell Pens for $20. And I highly recommend this, especially if you're looking for a nice flashy signature pen. This is the guy to have. Very nice, very good and weighty. Thanks.